Hi, this video is going to introduce PySCF, which is the underlying code of PyFLOSIC. With that, we would like to introduce how you install PySCF as well as its basic architecture. PySCF has its own documentation outlining all of the PySCF features. And in this documentation, it is already mentioned that PySCF is an efficient platform for quantum chemistry calculations, as well as code development. So with that, PySCF is the starting point for PyFLOSIC. Now, why do you use PySCF? First of all, PySCF includes many different levels of theory, ranging from density functional theory to wave function theories, which allows a direct comparison between different theories on the same footing. It's a user-friendly, efficient, multi-purpose electronic structure code with an intelligent usage of Python classes. It has a transparent development of new features using GitHub, which means at any moment, you can go online to GitHub and see what is going on in the code right now. It enables fast code development, which has been shown for the PySCF numerical atomic orbitals, as well as, of course, for PyFLOSIC. And allows an easy design of complex workflows using the intrinsic power of Python itself, as well as by employing Python packages like NumPy, SciPy, and others. Installing PySCF is very easy. The simplest way is using the pip Python package manager, where the only thing you have to do is to type pip3 install PySCF, which will install the latest version of PySCF to your system. There are other ways to obtain PySCF, for example, via git clone, but we're not going to go into detail in this video. As already mentioned, every method in PySCF is its own Python class. For example, we have classes for Hartree Fock calculations, which are called RHF as well as UHF, where R and U stand for restricted as well as unrestricted. Similarly, we have classes for cone sham density functional theory calculations called RKS and UKS. There are post Hartree Fock methods like MP2, CCSDT, and many, many more. And in addition, there are many, many more methods out there, like multi-configurational methods that I'm not going to talk about in this video. Now, given that all of these classes are built in a similar fashion, they're easy to learn, they're easy to use, and they're easy to modify for the user's needs in order to introduce new features, which, for example, has been done for the PyFLOSIC code. With that, I'd like to show you a very simple example for a DFT calculation. What I'm showing here is the entire Python script, which you can execute to run this DFT calculation. Up top, you import PySCF. With that, you import all of the PySCF features. Then you build your geometry object, including the atomic coordinates and the atomic species. In this case, we have an HF molecule with a distance of 1.1 angstrom. And we're using a basis set. This is a Dunning CC PBQZ. And this is all we need to run this very simple DFT calculation. What I want to show here is the differentiation between a restricted calculation and an unrestricted calculation, where in the restricted one, we're going to build ourselves a calculation object from the RKS class, That is the restricted cone sham. After which we define ourselves a specific exchange correlation functional. In this case, it's an LDA with a Purdue-Wong correlation part. And this last line here is gonna run the DFT calculation in the end. So this is all you need. Three lines of code to run the restricted calculation. And similarly, in the very same fashion, we have the unrestricted calculation where the only thing that we change is the class from RKS to UKS. We again use the same exchange correlation functional and run the calculation. Now this script here will already allow you to compare restricted cone sham versus unrestricted cone sham in a very simple workflow. And very similarly, we can go to quantum chemical calculations regarding Hard-Fock, CCSD, and CCSDT. As shown before, we first of all import PySCF and all its features. We construct ourselves our geometry object. This is still the HF molecule, where we use a slightly different basis set now. And we can do the same thing regarding the differentiation between restricted and unrestricted calculations, where first of all, we're gonna build ourselves an object from the RHF class and run the calculation. On top of this calculation, indicated here by MF, we run the CCSD calculation. And on top of this, we evaluate the energy for the perturbative triples for the CCSDT. And in the end, we print the correlation energy evaluated by this restricted CCSDT calculation. And in the very same way, we can do this entire calculation for the unrestricted case, where again, the only thing we gotta change is the class from RHF to UHF. Everything else stays the same. And these few lines of codes allow you to run Hartree-Fock, CCSD, as well as CCSDT in a very consistent workflow. So with that, I'd like to inspire you to stay tuned. First of all, we are at Twitter. The OpenSIC project is at Twitter, where we will update news as well as other things that you could tweet to us and we would respond. Furthermore, we have the YouTube channel where we upload these kind of videos. And we are at ResearchGate, where we will publish all the science that we are doing in this project. So with that, I would like to thank you for your attention and your time. Little summary here, Python itself is a way to code very efficiently. GitHub as well as GitLab offer very efficient ways to share code and to allow transparent science. And this presentation altogether has been done in web slides, which is a very nice and efficient way to make presentations, especially for young researchers. So with that, if you have any further questions, please let us know, and thank you for your attention.